So a lot of you asked me to make a tutorial about enemies, and here you go. Today I'll be showing you how to make a simple free states enemy. Patrolling when the player is far away, chasing when the player gets inside range, and attacking as soon as the player enters the attack range. Like always, make a new script, call it whatever you want, and let's start with the variables. Since we'll be using navmesh agents, you first want to make sure you're using unityengine.ai, and then get the reference to your agent. And also make a transform for the player, as well as two layer masks for what is ground and what is player. Now for the patrolling, you want to make a new vector free as a walk point, a bool to check if this walk point is already set, and a float to control the walk point range. For chasing, we don't need any variables, but for attacking, make a float time between attacks and a bool to check if you already attacked. And finally, make two floats for the sight and attack range, as well as two bools to check if the player is in range. Now, you don't want to set the variables manually, because you're probably going to have a lot of enemies. So in void awake, use the gameobject.find method to search for your player. Mine is named like this. But obviously this will be different for you, so definitely check what your player is called first. Also use getComponent to assign your navmesh agent. Now let's make the state functions. That would be patrolling, chase player and attack player. Open void update and let's check if the player is in sight or attack range. For this just say player in sight range equals physics.checksphere and use your position as a center, your sight range as range and what is player as layer mask. Same for the attack range, but this time use player in attack range and attack range. With that done, you can now make three simple statements. If the player is not in sight range nor in attack range, the enemy should patrol. If the player is in sight range but not in attack range, the enemy should chase the player, and as soon as the player also gets in attack range, the enemy should start attacking. So let's jump into the patrolling function. If the walk point is not set, you want to search a walk point. So make a new function for that. In there, make a float variable called randomz, and set it equal to random.range, your negative walk point range and your positive walk point range. This will just return a random value depending on how high your walk point range is. Copy this line and call the variable randomx. Now you can set the walk point to new vector 3, your x position plus randomx, your y position stays the same and your z position plus randomz. Just like that, you search for a random point, but this point could be outside of the map. So check with a raycast if this point is actually on the ground. If so, walk point set should be true. Now thanks to the navmesh agent, walking to this point is super easy. If your walk point is set, just say agent.setDestination walk point. That's it. Also, you want to calculate the distance to your walk point like this. And if the distance is less than 1, you reach the walk point, and walk point set should be false again. Now it's automatically going to search a new one. Now chase player is a lot easier to code. Just say agent.setDestination player.position, and that's it. Inside of the attack player function, you then want to stop the enemy from moving with agent.setDestination transform.position. Also say transform.lookAt player, because when the enemy is attacking, you probably want it to look at the player. Now for attacking, make a reset attack function. Check if you haven't already attacked, and if so, set already attacked to true. And invoke the reset attack function with your time between attacks as a delay. Inside of the reset attack function, just set already attacked to false again. Now, what else you put in here of course depends on what kind of attack you want. This could be shooting, a sword attack, or pretty much anything else. For this tutorial, I'm just going to instantiate a new projectile and add forward and upward force to it. If you want to follow along here, you need to watch my two-part tutorial series on shooting with bullets and custom projectiles. If you want to be able to damage the enemies, you also need a take damage function and a health variable, but once again, for this it would be best to watch the series. Finally, you can add this if you want to visualize the attack and sight range. Now, before continuing, click the link in the description and import the navmesh components. Inside of Unity, select your enemy, add a navmesh agent, and you can pretty much leave it default, but maybe change the speed or acceleration. Then you need to make a new object, add the navmesh surface component and just hit bake. Finally, you can add the script to your enemy and set all of the variables. I personally use something like this. Also, you make the two layer masks and put your ground in what is ground and your player in what is player. You should now have a working enemy AI that you can use for pretty much all sorts of games. But now, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe and remember, you can download the code in the description and the whole project file for free over my Discord. Don't be ashamed to ask questions, and if everything worked for you, maybe quickly check the comments if someone needs help.